Now sit back, relax, and I hope you enjoy. Much love to all.
Ask yourself this: what concern would an angel have with a dead, decaying body after all the life force had left it? That could be why they told Mary and them that the man they sought was not there. The angels asked them, why were they seeking the living amongst the dead? Christians claim that the Shroud of Turin is the identical shroud that the body of Yahshua, Jesus, was laid in after his supposed crucifixion. There are marks that appear on the shroud, one being images of a body. Shroudists state that this cloth had been laid lengthwise on the body, beginning at the heels and proceeding up the back to the base of the skull, over the head and down to the toes. The picture portrayed on the shroud is of a man with an owl-shaped face, eyes opened and a long nose. The mouth is only a smudge beneath the nostrils. The hair appeared to be long and stringy, hanging to the shoulders. A comparison can be made, and from this you will clearly see how it would be impossible for Jesus to have been a resurrected spirit from the dead. The moving of the rock was proof that neither one of them had spiritualized, because the spirit could go through solid rock. Yet the rock doors had to be moved by someone in order for the physical body of those two men to come forth. When Yahshua's tomb was entered that Sunday morning, the body was gone and the shroud, burial linen, etc. was left there. When Lazarus came forth from his grave, Yahshua, Jesus, ordered his disciples to remove the grave clothes that bound him. Further information that Lazarus was not, and neither was Yahshua, a resurrected spirit, because you cannot bind a spirit with material. This also proves that the shroud of Lazarus and Jesus was not just laid on the body as shroudists say, otherwise when he rose from the tomb, the cloth would have simply fallen to the ground and there would not have been any need for someone to loosen the grave clothes that bound him. The truth of the matter is that Yahshua, Jesus, did not resurrect spiritually or otherwise from the dead, because he was not dead. Mary didn't realize that it was Yahshua because he had physically transformed himself and his appearance was different. He still wore the clothes he had taken while in the gardener's shed, John chapter 20 verse 14. Yahshua knew that if they thought he was still alive, they would seek to kill him. He could not take that chance. Just as they tried to crucify him, they tried to kill him at birth, so why wouldn't he think they would still try to kill him? Today, if Yahshua were to return, what would actually happen? People would try to kill him again. Anyone who thinks that they are the Messiah or Christ, they are killed. Like David Koresh, as soon as he claimed to be Christ, the government came down on him and bombed his whole community in Waco, Texas. At the time of the fight between the disciples and the Roman soldiers in the Garden of Gethsemane, Yahshua fled towards the gardener's shed, and at the same time the disciples fled also. Once the scuffle took place, Yahshua took the opportunity to flee from the garden into the gardener's shed. The soldiers grabbed hold of Yahshua's robe, cloth he had draped around him, and he, continuing to run, left the robe behind and fled naked to the gardener's shed. Yahshua then disguised himself in the gardener's clothes and stayed in the shed for 3 days and did not make himself public, cloaking himself in the gardener's own clothes. Now remember, he was never in the tomb, he was hiding in the shed when they grabbed someone else. This is how he gained access to the gardening clothes. Yahshua told Mary to tell his disciples that he had ascended. If Yahshua did not ascend, could he have died? If he had died and if he was resurrected, he would not have any reason to be afraid. Why? Because the resurrected body can't die twice. Who says so? Your Bible says so, so you can reject that. Mary then proceeded to embrace Yahshua. He stopped her and told her, "Don't get happy yet, because you see me, I have not ascended to my Father. But go tell them that I did." In other words, Yahshua told her to tell a lie. Christians say that Yahshua was speaking in a future tense. He told Mary to tell his disciples, "Ascend unto my Father," meaning he will ascend. Okay, fine, but remember that this incident took place after the so-called resurrection from the tomb to the cross and after the so-called resurrection from the tomb. Now you can choose either. Jesus had not been crucified, didn't ascend on the cross or tomb, but wanted to tell everyone he will. Jesus lied because he had already ascended but wanted to tell everyone he was going to ascend in the future. Jesus had another incident of ascension in mind other than the resurrection everyone mistakenly thought took place.
Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon. Till the next time, much love.